actually.
Sleeping Beauty?
Beauty and the Beast.
Oh, okay, Beauty and the Beast. Got it.
Network in this region is shipshape once again. I'll get some of our staff to see if they can find anything about that.
Yeah, because I knew everybody else, but I could never figure out Blake. But now that I think about it, because she's a Faunalise, that makes perfect sense.
Yeah, she's Faunus and shit like that, so.
Mermello Katniss. Blake and Adam. Is Adam the other Faunus? Or Faunalise?
Adam's the one that was in the black trailer.
For any clues about who did this, we're all counting on you.
The guy with the red hair?
Yeah.
Is it?
Okay. Like, he hasn't shown up except for like at the end of Volume 2.
Now we're talking. Yeah, because I know he showed up briefly, but I know it wasn't for very long in the actual show.
Yeah, he's shown that he's gonna be on the evil, the bad side of the. He's in cahoots with Cinder and Emerald and Mercury and all them. That's all we know about him.
Blade becomes chargeable, turns to Earth.
I just reset my
screen. I kind of don't want to upgrade the Earth one, but I think I might have to.
Okay, cool. I got it fixed. Cool.
You got it?
I had to stop streaming and start streaming again.
Okay. When it sees you, it will spin before it charges. Let's go Aura Recovery probably here. It will be disoriented after it passes. That's when you strike. No, it's been so long since I watched, like, the first two volumes of RWBY. I really need to watch it again so I can remember who everybody is, because their names escape me.
I've been keeping up with it, and I've basically... Actually, I have both Volume 1 and 2 on Blu-ray, so...
Oh, nice.
Keep using
Have all the volumes on Crunchyroll, so I tend to just watch it on there.
I forgot, I'm going for Sunbreaker this time around.
Nice. I'm kind of just playing whatever is Blake, just so I can get some more unlocks. That's gonna leave a mark. Ow! God, she got me! Oh, double yang this game. What's good? How it's done. I think this is probably the first game I've played in like the 12 hours I put into this game that there's been no RWBY.
I wasn't gonna play RWBY because I honestly think that if I'm gonna play all four characters that she's gonna be the last I work on to get everything done with her, so...
Mm.
I'm actually only playing Yang right now because I didn't want to play Blake. Right now, I'll probably play Blake next time around.
Yeah. Yeah, Blake's growing on me. I still haven't found my love for White yet, gameplay-wise, but I'm starting to enjoy Blake a little bit more.
Yeah, for me, the only problem I'm having with Blake is the fact that I want to do all the mastery for her, so it's difficult.
Mm-hmm.
I mean... Blast Wave took me forever with Yang, but I finally got it.
Yeah, Blast Wave took a really long time. You need to make a prayer circle for Volume 3 OST? Oh man, tell me about it.
I can't wait for the soundtrack for Volume 3 to drop. Oh my god, everything I've heard so far is amazing.
It's the Yangarang.
Oh,
Kitchen. That cost... Okay, it cost one. Yeah, Yeah, I love Jeff Williams and his daughter, man. They make some damn good music.
Jeff and Casey, oh my god.
Yeah, dude. Like, I can listen to their stuff all damn day.
I still think my favorite song is Caffeine from Volume 2, so, I mean...
Yeah, Caffeine's a good one. I'm really in love with Gold. That's hands down my favorite. Got this. Oh, God. So many wolfies.
I love when you go into the ability menu, everything just becomes so much quieter.
Oh man, let me see here. Almost there. Points. I kind of want to go Shadow Blitz, but I really need to work on unlocking these other 15. Okay, yeah, we'll just go improve Blade Beam here. Oh no, Metal Aura. Hell yeah, Gold. Damn right, Kitchen. The song is excellent.
What other songs?
Say Boop is the rest because it's hella cute.
What other songs do I like? I like Die. Die is another one I like from Volume 2.
Yeah, I remember, I remember the first time I heard. I forget the name of the song, but the original opening theme, but they, on the Volume 1 soundtrack, they did a acoustic version of it.
Oh yeah, This Will Be the Day.
Yeah, This Will Be the Day. Man, the acoustic version of that is so good.
Sure you can!
Oh. Oh man, I just wish that Blake had a little more AoE.
Yeah, that's why I like.
Like her Shadow Strike is really good, but only when it's upgraded to max.
Yeah, because the
like,
fire.
Prior to max level, it's just not that good.
One thing I do have to complain about, though, is the fact that out of all of them, Blake doesn't sound like the same voice actress. I don't know if it's just me or not, but whenever I hear Blake...
Yeah, I mean, she seems a little, like, disinterested. Like, I've heard that complaint before on the forums that the Blake voice acting is not like as great
as like in the show. She sounds great.
Yeah.
In the show.
Oh my god, I died.
She's great in the show. It's just in the
oh,
game.
Okay. Kitchen said it's not the same voice actress.
Why wouldn't that's interesting.
Yeah.
Why would they go with a different voice actress for the game? I wonder.
Kitchen says she was busy at the time, so only the grunts and sound effects are in. Or Aaron, I guess that's the voice actress's name.
Yeah.
So the grunts and sound effects are her, but the dialogue is RWBY's voice actress.
So that means Lindsay does the voice acting for Blake.
Yeah, I'm already level 7. I feel like I'm leveling really quick this run.
See, that sounds lucky for you, because I've... Well, then again, I haven't been... I've been trying to set up my stream this entire time, so... I'm a little lower level.
Yeah, true. You missed out on, like, the first half.
I was going to say, I'm only level 5. You're level 7. With Blake, that's amazing. That means you might actually hit 10.
I mean, maybe, but if I really wanted the level 10 thing, I would just do a playthrough. I might do it later after I stop streaming, but I don't think I'm going to go meet up with my buddy because it's already 7:20. I'll probably stream for a few more hours, though.
See, it's 7:20 for you, it's almost 10:30 for me.
Yeah, the glories of being on the West Coast.
Well, yeah, true. Then again, I'm used to staying up pretty late in the day for myself, so being up this late is not uncommon.
Yeah, sometimes I'll be up till like 4 in the morning. It just really depends.
See, if it's
'cause right now I don't have like a 9-to-5 job. I'm just doing like contract work while I'm looking for employment. So my schedule can be different from day to day.
I'm part-time where I'm at, so it doesn't really matter.
Oh, okay. Yeah, like, I'm trying to get a dedicated stream schedule up on my info, but I don't really know what times I'm gonna have right now, so I can't, like, submit to anything in particular.
Since I've had the last 3 days off, I've been able to stream daily, but that's beside the point. For the most part, I would probably only stream maybe once every other, maybe once a week, not this often.
Halfway point, team.
Especially since my streams go straight to YouTube after I'm done streaming.
Oh, nice. Yeah, I don't have a YouTube set up. I should probably get on that.
It's
so I can
really
put my past broadcasts up there.
Yeah, it's nice to have a YouTube set up for people to watch your past streams and other stuff. I also have a YouTube set up for like actual Let's Plays and stuff, so
yeah, I mean, I really should have recorded my blind playthrough of Undertale and put it up on YouTube, but I didn't think about it.
That's a game I need to play eventually.
Have you not played Undertale yet?
I have not.
Oh man, do yourself a favor and do not watch any streams of it. Just buy it and play it through.
That's what I want to do. That's why anybody who talks about the game, I'm just like, please don't talk to me about that game. Not because I don't like it, but because I don't want it spoiled, honestly.
Yeah, which is good. Like, that's why I was doing a second playthrough. I started yesterday and I was doing more of it before upstream with RWBY. And I had a couple people come and go, but I didn't get too many viewers doing Undertale, and there was one guy that came in, he was trying to talk about the game, and I wasn't mad or anything by any means, but I just told him, like, hey, you know, try not to spoil anything, because I don't know about the people in chat, because, you know, some people like to watch blind playthroughs because they want to experience it for the first time, like, with streamers or whatever it is.
Like, some people
kind of like see the reactions. Right.
Like, for me, there are certain games I have not played only because I've gotten enough out of it by watching other people play it.
Yeah, exactly. So, like, you know, sometimes people tune into streams and they've never seen it before and they want to experience everything like as it happens. And sometimes you get people that, you know, they don't ruin the story on purpose, but they start talking about it. So I try to give, when I do things like that, I try to give everybody a fair warning. Just like, hey, you know, try not to spoil anything. Like, I'll usually tell people to just send me a, yeah, I know, Kitchen. Talk about gold in the song, please. I try to just tell people to whisper me if they want to talk about stuff that's going to happen later in the game.
Right. Yeah, I get what you mean, though.
Yeah, because that way you still get the commentary, you still get to talk to your viewers, but for the people that may not want to hear it, they don't have to see it in the chat.
Exactly. The only thing I do is, like, if I'm playing a game that's, like, depends on how old the game is for me. If the game isn't, like, if the game's, like, 10 years old and you haven't played it, that's kind of your fault.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
Like, if I'm playing through an old Pokemon game, I don't expect anybody to care if they get spoiled. It's like, like, why would you care?
Onward to victory!
Also, from what I hear, a lot of people like to say all Pokemon games are the same, and they kind of are, because you do the same thing, but at the same time, different Pokemon and different things, it makes them different, I guess. Doesn't matter.
Yeah. Oh, dude. Kitchen, I can't bring myself to do that, man. I tried, but I just couldn't.
Oh, I'm going to run away.
Either way, I believe it should be worth investigating the Below Industries building in Mountain Glen. If my old maps are still accurate, it should be located somewhere near.
Like, I went to do it, and I, I ended up doing it the normal way. They just... My heart couldn't take it.
The only thing I have to bring about Undertale that I do know about is the music. There's one song in particular people like to talk about a lot, and I'm just like, okay, just so you know, that song came from another place first. And that song would be...
Yeah, I mean...
Megalovania is one people like to talk about a lot.
The Undertale soundtrack is absolutely amazing. I'm probably gonna buy it next month when I have a bit more cash.
I know that there's, like I said, there's one song on there that didn't originate from Undertale, actually, so that's the fun part for me. Especially since I know where it originated, and then its second usage was somewhere else as well. The song's called Megalovania, and it originated from a Earthbound Halloween hack.
Oh, interesting. I think I might know what song you're talking about.
And then the second usage of the song actually was in the webcomic Homestuck.
No One Can Kitchen? Yeah. I was watching a stream that was doing one of those runs, and they were like near the end on one of the last fights, and I closed it after like a good 30 seconds because I just couldn't. I'm trying so hard to get fucking kills with Dust Clone, but it's very hard.
I know, that's what I was trying to do that last time I played as Blake.
Taking out the trash.
Yeah, gang, we're taking out the trash.
Oh, boxes, come to me. Nice, 25 XP.
And that artifact.
All right, nice, I'll hit level 8. Sick.
I haven't even hit 7. God dang.
Well, that's an issue. The bridge is blocked.
It's a good thing I've already gotten 10 with Yang, so I don't really care that much about it.
Yeah, I've hit 10 with RWBY and Yang.
Again, I have not used.
I do want to get Blake's.
I want to get Blake's too, and then once I'm done with Blake and all of her mastery, I'll probably move on to Weiss.
Yeah, I mean, I'll probably give Weiss another shot, but
I think I'm just gonna try to get all of them done for all four characters at some point, and then once I'm done with that,
I'm just G-Gang, you're taking me out. Sorry, what were you saying, Austin?
I said I'm probably gonna unlock everything for all four characters, and then I'm just gonna stick with Yang and Blake as my favorite, as the two that I use the most.
Yeah, I'm probably gonna end up making RWBY and Yang my two, like main squeezes, so to speak.
Right. I'd definitely like to get into a lobby where we have four Yangs, though. That would be awesome. Actually.
Oh, that would be that would be pretty legit. Not gonna lie. This might be my last RWBY run. I might move on to some Mojo Rampage or something like that, but we'll see how I feel at the end of the run.
I'll continue talking to you, though. I'm going to continue streaming RWBY for a bit.
Alright, no worries. Yeah, and like, this Discord server isn't just for my stream in particular. This is something I just made for people that like indie games, so, you know, anybody that wants to join, it's more than welcome. I'm always trying to get people to show up in there. I'm always asking if anybody wants to play games and stuff, so... If you're ever looking for people to play with, just send me like an at mention in there or something, and I'll be around. My name in that chat is Dude What the Fuck Bro, though. It's not endemic.
That moment when you walk up to somebody to revive them and your B button isn't working. Well, for me, I guess that's my circle button, because PS3 controller.
No. I need to edit my Steam controller to work with this game, because it doesn't work by default.
That's suckish. Like, because I had my PS3 controller plugged in, and it automatically worked.
I'm back, Scrubs.
Hello. What's up, dude?
Is Austin slacking still?
I finally got my stream set up the way I wanted it.
Yeah, he's slacking it. Don't let him fool you. He didn't do anything like the first half of the game.
Hey. I'm just gonna yang in there and, you know, just keep going.
That was an unintentional pong.
No, that was done on purpose. I'm gonna yang in there.
I'm gonna yang in there. Oh, yang.
Not only are they based off of different fairy tale characters, but they're also, characters of fairy tales, but, they're also based off of the characters that voice them, actually, so...
Oh, interesting.
Let me tell you, Barbara Dunkelman is definitely the punniest person you'll ever meet. And she's also blonde and big boobs, so, you know.
It was so funny in that latest episode when fucking Neon. The chick was making fun of Yang. She's like, you're top heavy. Yang gets all pissed off.
I'm not saying you should go on a diet. I'm saying you really need to go on a diet.
Yeah. That got me, dude. Oh my god, that got me so hard.
I still like the whole design behind Quentin Cole, though.
Really? I didn't really like his whole, like, design semblance thing.
It was interesting for me only because it's like, they've never had an instrument as a weapon yet.
Yeah, that's true. I mean, it's interesting in that fact, but other than that, I was like, meh. And yeah, Kitchen, god damn it, Neon Cat.
Sure, you can all of the things.
All the damn things.
Sure, you can.
Oh, and now it's just the Ursa.
Oh, Ursa, please.
Nailed it.
Ah, the door is open.
Final wave complete. Two.
Nailed it.
Nailed it, boys.
I burn, can't hold. Yeah, no, I can't sing either.
Oh, what the fuck? Adam's playing Rocksmith? Man. Since his son was born, I have barely seen him online. I did see him in Skype the other day, though. Oh, gotta get that relic. So what do you guys think is going to happen to Tierra? This applies to chat as well, guys. I'm not just talking in Discord, by the way.
You're talking about Tierra as in, like, the next episode of RWBY?
Yeah, the next episode of RWBY, like, how she's going to be, like, the Guardian or something? At least that was implied.
That's what's implied, but a lot of people are like, this is just what's going to happen, and then it's going to just be RWBY like everyone expects.
Hmm.
Because RWBY does make the most sense.
But, like, what the hell is a Guardian? Like, was that talked about before?
Yeah, it was talked about earlier on in the series. Or not in the series, in the season.
I'll have to go back and see what that was about.
Somebody can look up to and count upon.
I'm trying to see where that fence was that I got stuck in. Oh, I think, was it this one? No. It's whatever. I don't need to find it, because honestly, if I find it again, I'll get stuck again.
Mike.
I'm not buying that she's Neo.
Oh, people are. Yeah, people have that this thing where they think that the Pyrrha that's going in the elevator isn't actually Pyrrha and it's Neo in disguise.
Huh. Interesting.
We still don't know if, because people think that Neo's semblance is going to be being able to turn into other people and disguising herself as other people, blah, blah, blah. And, that...
Which one is Neo again?
The one with the, pink and brown hair, the one that messed with Yang in the freaking train.
Oh, yeah, okay. Okay, yeah.
Ah.
Miss Umbrella.
Oh my god, I'm down. Bad.
You suck.
Yeah, Kitchen. I don't buy it either. I don't think that's the case. I have to agree with you there.
I think it might be Neo based on the smile that she had, but that's beside the point.
Don't you guys
know? Small adorable dual colored murder girl.
Don't you guys wish you had a RWBY right now?
I've got 10 seconds.
Nah, we're good. We'll be fine. Oh, it didn't give me the experience for it. I'll save this to update Sunbreaker to its final.
Pyrrha's like the smirkiest. She's always smirking. Yeah, you're true. Or you're right. I mean, that's true. She's definitely kind of like that, not cocky, but just very like confident but caring type of character.
But the only reason she likes John is because he doesn't know about all of her feats. He doesn't like her because she's her. He likes her because she's a good friend.
Well, I feel like Pyrrha is just like a little jaded when it comes to people and just a little socially awkward because so many people are like, oh, wow, like you accomplished all this stuff, blah, blah, blah. And she just gets kind of sick of it.
Exactly.
Kind of like somebody, it's kind of like a celebrity who's been famous for like 20 years. It just gets annoying after a while, you know?
You want to have friends who like you for who you are, not what you did.
Exactly. Which makes me feel really sorry for Pyrrha. Like, so sad.
Grimm, attack me. I want you to deplete my aura. Reason why I'm completely standing still and letting them do so.
Oh, come at me, bear.
There we go. Sure you can.
Oh, the Sunbreaker.
But yeah, I think that last game was officially we used the most overpowered Kyoto in the game.
Dude, I could just like imagine a game full of like 4 RWBYs. Be so stupid. Jesus.
It'll be hard taking down like the big
like four RWBYs or 4 Yangs.
4 RWBYs, 4 Yangs, or 4 Weisses. 4 Blakes is a little not fun. I don't think you could do 4 Blakes, honestly.
Unless everybody just went like full Shadow Strike build and just spam the shit out of it for all the clones. That'd be pretty baller. Feel sorry for Pyrrha. Because John's denser. Because John's denser than the core of Earth.
He kind of is, yeah.
I mean, Kitchen, you're not wrong, dude. You're definitely not wrong. I like when he's trying to explain how he wants his team to use that special attack in the other episode.
Oh,
he spends like a good 5 minutes trying to tell them what to do.
Flower power!
Yeah, and they're just like, what the fuck are you talking about?
Flower power, It's your symbols.
It's your thing. Your semblance. I mean, no, you know, throw the thing.
Ren brings the flower while Nora brings the power. Why would I bring the flower? No, not a flower. Flower! Like you're baking.
Oh, God, John. Sometimes, man.
John's is one of those people you can just laugh with.
Yeah. And John's one of those characters that you just can't help but love.
You can laugh with and at him at the same time.
Yeah.
Which is awkward, I know, but it works with him.
Our co-star names put together. Do you not like it?
Let's just call him Vomit Boy again, please.
It killed me when John went, thank you very little.
And we're in the middle of a conversation. Thank you very little.
Oh, man. Yeah, some of the moments in that show are just priceless.
Also, Edemic.
What's up, man?
Apparently, you were not understanding what I was trying to say a couple of days ago, whatever. I said I watched season 1 and 2 3 times.
Yeah, I remember. At first, I thought you said 23 times, but then you corrected me.
I know you were having the hardest problems trying to get it through your head, but...
I know I've watched them a good number of times, but, like, not 23, definitely. No.
Dude, I can watch it 23 times.
That's why when I first thought...
You give me some popcorn and soda, and I'm in for the match. Not meant for the long road.
When I first thought that you were saying 23, dude, I was like, I love this show too, but man, that might be a little too much for even me.
Like, I may have watched it 4 times even.
What gave them the idea that this acid Grimm thing was a good idea?
Totally did not watch RWBY 23 times. Nuh-uh. Hey, look, a distraction. Kitchen, please, Ellie Giggle.
Excellent work, team. Hey, Demick.
What's up, man?
Would you be willing to try EverQuest?
Possibly. Definitely not today.
Yeah.
I'm gonna do some other stuff on stream before I call it a night.
I thought you had to go meet your friend, too.
Yeah, I was supposed to do that, but I decided to just stay home.
And kick ass.
Yeah, I was like, I'm having fun with RWBY. Chat's actually active today. So, I was having a good time, so I decided to stay here. I can always meet up with him tomorrow or something. Ain't too big of a deal.
See, the only thing is you're gonna leave the game RWBY, and you're gonna go play another game, right? Well, you should have went out with a Yang then.
Oh my god, the bad puns are bad.
Dude, it's Bobble Punkleman.
Yes.
Maybe that's what I'll do after I'm done streaming. I'll just put on a host for somebody and then call it a night and go to watch some more RWBY.
I usually never get enough stream viewers to go with a host or to go host somebody. Usually if I have anybody watching my stream, it's like 1 or 2 people. So it's like, if I go
host, yeah. No, I totally get you, man. I'm the same way. Like, I think today I peaked out at about 12 or 13 viewers about an hour or two ago. But my normal is about, 2 or 3 is my average.
I wish I could stream.
But the only reason that I even put on a host is just so... you know, in case any of my regulars show up, if I'm not around, you know, hopefully they'll hop into the hosted stream and kind of check out other people that I enjoy.
I might host somebody when I'm done streaming tonight, depending on if he goes live or not.
Yeah, because, I mean, I try to, for the most part, follow streamers that are a lot like myself. People that like to interact with their chat, you know, they play, like, indie games or do blind playthroughs, things like that. Okay. I don't necessarily follow a lot of big streamers.
Well, I don't follow too many big streamers either. Most of the people I watch stream are people who I watch on YouTube, and then they just happen to stream every so often.
Oh, you guys are getting ballsy going for my res right there. Oh, you guys both have the Sunbreaker glitch on. That's awesome.
Wait, do I have it? I don't see it on my screen, so...
On my screen, it is. You guys both have it. Because it's a bug that happens on, like, your computer specifically. It's not server-side. It's client-side.
So basically, it'll only show up for other people to see?
No, it can happen when you're playing as Yang. But what I'm saying is, like, sometimes it'll happen, like, on your screen, right? And you'll see the fire around you constantly. But then somebody else in the game might not be able to see it.
So you got, like, you can see it on me, but I can't see it on me.
Yeah, exactly.
Which kind of sucks. I would have loved to have seen it on myself.
Yeah, it looks pretty sick. I mean, if you look at my stream real quick, you can see it.
It's fine. I don't really need to see it. It's like... Especially since I saw you have it the other time.
Yeah, true. Right. Forget that. Just her. Save the cat, girlfriend.
Whee!
Dude, cat girls... I mean, I'm more of a dog person myself, but, I mean... Hurry, gather those dust
crystals. I'm a cat person. I can go for it.
I mean, let's be real. If I had to choose between Blake or Zwei, we all know who's going to win that one.
I mean, it's obviously the thing that can fit inside of a freaking package.
Yeah, they send Zwei in a fucking, like...
A tube.
Tiny-ass little tube. He just plops out, and then there's, like, 80 cans of dog food.
Like, dude,
oh, geez.
He became a fucking fireball.
Tai Yang, how did you fit him in there?
I know, right?
Dude,
like you just stuffed him in.
Fireball.
Oh god, whatever you do, don't die.
Acid Grimm got me, damn it.
I've got 20 seconds. Wow, all three of us went down, man. Those explosions. Too strong. Run, Yang, run! Yeah, I think we did miss an artifact. I think it was... Back to the right, maybe. I'm actually going to go back and check, because... I'm kind of close to... Oh, shit. No. Might be able to get level 10. Huntress has fallen.
I went down to more acid, Grimm.
You die on top of Blake. If you die on top of Blake, do it for the ship. See, I'm 300 away from... Oh my god. So many explosion guys. Oh, run.
Responding in 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Respawn. Oh my god.
I don't know if I'm going to be able to get you, Mert. Oh, nope.
No fuel left in the car.
Hurry,
gather those dust crystals.
Shit.
Sure you can.
Oh, God. Oh, that was brutal. I just tried to use my Shadow Strike, and I blew myself up.
Oh, well, fuck.
I wouldn't even try to res us, dude.
Yeah.
Oh, somebody DC'd.
It was the other Yang.
Who was that, Mermello, I think?
No, that was Mark Nutt.
Back in action. Mark Nutt. Oh, audience. If you reload, you can come right back in. It should just instantly boost you to around the same level you were at.
Yeah, that's what I like about rejoining. At least you don't lose levels.
Yeah.
You join a pre-started game, you get the level about where everyone else is.
Yeah, you get like the average.
Which I might actually try to do that for Blake if I want to. I might join in a pre-started game with Blake and just see how that runs. I might be able to get the level done that way.
Maybe. God, it's so close to level 10. I'll definitely get it by the end of this.
Oh, now I have a visual effect.
Nice.
So, who thinks we might end up accidentally failing this?
Yeah, we might, actually. I want to try to at least get to that last room, though, so I can get that artifact for level 10 and get this kill, possibly. There we go. Where's that other dust at? Did somebody grab it?
There's no fuel left in the car. Hurry, gather those dust
crystals. Star Killer.
50 seconds. No. I'm so close.
Stop killing me. Oh my god.
Oh, I'm so close to getting this fucking level 10. Come on. Get the kill. No. I'm like 100 away. Oh, so close. Oh my god, no way. I'm like the closest ever. I'm gonna be so salty. Ah, come on. Come on. No, 12 seconds.
We're gonna fail, no.
Ah, I'm not gonna get level 10. Oh my god. I'm literally 25 away. I'm 10 away, dude. No, I was 10 away. Ah.
I've never seen what happens when you fail.
Stream, why?
I did it once just to see what happened, just out of curiosity.
Oh, stream, why? Why does this happen to me?
Oh, you have a chance to do it again.
I'm like, I just feel defeated at this point now, though. Like, because I was so close, I'm just like, welp.
Well, at least you'll be able to try to do it now.
Yeah, that's true. Your virtual machine crashed? You don't have a, you don't have, like, a dedicated PC?
Actually, I might be able to reach level 10 now. Shit.
On audience, don't be sorry, man. It's not your fault if your system crashed. Like, you got nothing to be sorry for, man. I need someone to play with me so we can die together for angst shipping. What do you mean? Sorry if that was supposed to be a joke, Kitchen. If it was, that one went right over my head, bud. I'll get the dust over here.
Actually, why don't we, how about you go try to get to level 10? I'll worry about dust.
Alright. Got 10 experience away, man. Oh, the salt was real.
Oh, AH Marknut wants to do the dust. No, I was gonna say, he joined... Yeah, all his stuff got reset, so...
Oh, shit.
Get halfway
there.
Keep going.
Oh! Blown up.
Seems to have run out of fuel.
Yeah, Kitchen, I just got it.
You got level 10?
No, not yet. I need 300 more, but the artifact in the last room gives 100, so I really only need 200.
Nope.
Oh, careful. Yeah, don't get greedy. I can just wait for my timer. It's only 20 seconds. Oh, Marmello, careful. Oh, nice res.
It might be low power, but it's good at killing low health Grimm.
Oh, what? Where is this guy coming from? Ow! Jeez.
Oh. I didn't have enough to activate that.
Ow, fuck. Alright, awesome. Yeah, once you pick up that last artifact, I should hit it. I need exactly 100, so... Nice!
That last Sunbreaker... Took out an Ursa.
Oh, yeah. The triple Sunbreaker, right?
The Star Killer.
Yeah. I love Star Killer, dude. So good.
Nailed it.
Got him, coach. Shit, I'm trying to change the music on my thing right now. Shadowcat unlocked. Boom. Blake has a random chance to gain one special after defeating each enemy. Wow, that's pretty damn good.
For level 10?
Yeah, her level 10 ability. So that could actually be pretty good. If you're using Shadow Strike and you're wiping out a bunch of dudes.
No.
Definitely not bad.
Yang on Yang. Thank you.
Yang on Yang on Yang. Oh, move. I'm coming. We can make it. I think I'm slowly dying.
Who still needs experience? Because I'm not going to reach level 10, so it doesn't matter how much I gain.
Yeah, I'm already level 10. And I think the cart's almost up there, isn't it?
The cart's already...
I'm glad everyone was able to keep their cool and not explode.
Yeah, nice. We got it. An uncomfortable parent-teacher conference.
Where in the world did the mutated Grimm come from?
Oh, this guy. Nice. So we got our level 10 thing.
That means you've gotten Blake done. I still need to get Blake done.
Alright, guys. Well, we have been at RWBY for a few hours now. I'm gonna go ahead and take a restroom break real quick, get some more water, and I think I'll probably stream some Full Mojo Rampage. If not that, maybe, I don't know, we'll look through the Steam library, but more than likely gonna be Full Mojo Rampage, maybe some Rayman Legends as well. But give me about 2-3 minutes, I'll be back in stream. And yeah, we'll go from there.
And anybody interested in continuing to at least watch RWBY, I mean, I guess you can jump over to my stream and watch that, and I'll be continuing that.
Yeah, definitely. If you guys want more RWBY content, definitely head over to Hollowed Stream. There, he's got a webcam. He can wave to you, do all that good stuff. But I'll be back if you guys want to see something else. If you guys want more RWBY, definitely go hang out with Hollow. He's a great guy, fun gameplay. You guys can always hop in some games with him as well.
Seem to attract some Grimm. Happy hunting.
Blake strategy, join a game halfway started and see if I can get that to level 10.
Alrighty guys, and we are back.
Hooray.
Hey, Edmonic.
Yeah, what's up, man?
Would you be up for doing Borderlands 2, by chance?
Borderlands 2? Like a full playthrough, or what?
Borderlands 2, full playthrough, non-playthrough, I don't know. I like Borderlands 2.
Yeah, it's... Borderlands 2, definitely a fun game. I actually done that in a long time.
I actually have two level 72 characters, the Gunzoko and a Psycho.
Nice.
And yeah. Let's just say, for Melee Psycho, so much fun.
Alright, Mermelo Kitchen. You guys are probably already gone, but in case you're still around, thanks for tuning in. It was fun playing with you guys. Catch you next time. As for Borderlands 2, I would be down, but I don't have it installed. So when I'm done streaming tonight, I'll install it, and maybe we can play tomorrow or sometime later this week. Definitely.
Okay, well, what else we got then? No, Battleblock Theater, I don't have that downloaded. How long would it...
It's pretty big. I think it's a couple gigs, actually. Get ready.
Oh, you know what? I actually have it downloaded.
Nice.
So we can play that, because I never played it before!
Talking about games on your Steam library that you haven't played before, I have yet to touch any of my Castle Crashers.
Really?
I've played Castle Crashers.
It's a good game. I played it on Xbox with some friends when I was over at their place, but that's about it. I haven't really indulged in playing it by myself at all.
Two friends playing that.
Students, we're a quarter of the way there. Keep up the good work.
Oh my god, I'm just now playing the game and it's giving me a whole lot.
Oh, are you logged into Battleblock Theater?
Yeah. Well, you want to play with me?
I'm looking over my Steam library. I'm not sure what I'm going to do.
My Steam library is too small for me to just decide, oh, what game do you guys want to play? Oh, I don't have that many games to choose from.
Right now I'm at 135 games, and my wish list has 20 at the moment.
I have 70 games at the moment.
I think I may have like 7 games.
But you're not doing the PC Master Race correctly, then.
It's just because I don't, I haven't had time to play too many games, and I don't spend my money on too many of the PC games, only because I don't... Well, one, I don't have time to, so I usually opt to buy games for my 3DS.
Oh, yeah, If you're spending money on 3DS games
over PC games, you're doing it wrong.
It's only because I prefer playing my games on the go if I can, because I don't have time to be at home and play games, usually. If I'm at home and I'm playing games, it's very rare, actually. That's why I buy games for the Wii 3DS. But I've been home the last couple days, so I've been back into the swing of playing some PC games. And this is one that I've been awaiting since they announced its creation. So like, the excitement for this was just too big.
Let's see here.
So A game I do want to get back into playing is Don't Starve Together.
See, I bought Don't Starve, and I have the Don't Starve Together beta as well. I don't know, like, anytime I try to get into those survival-type games, I get bored really quickly.
It's easy to do so, I understand it.
I kind of have a like-hate thing with Don't Starve. I mean, I like it for its concept, but it's just so dumb on how hard you have to try for the first couple of days, and... After that, it's just...
It's my problem with it is it's easy to get lost.
All right, bad guys, got a phone call.
Yeah, that too. I've never been one for riddles and history. More of a man of action if I do that. I mean, I get so far into it and I'm like, what do I do now?
It's a survival game. It's basically you do the same thing you would in like Minecraft or something. You literally.
But yeah, but I mean, at least there's a bit of a guide to it though in Minecraft. And
true, like they give you instructions on what you're supposed to do.
Yeah, and don't stop like, oh, here's a world. Have fun.
Interfering with our security network. Let's see.
Oh, it might be everything. Either way, I believe it should be worth investigating.
I'm just hoping I can get Blake to level 10 here, because I've been trying for so long to get Blake to level 10, and it's just not easy. That's what I'm really worried about right now. I'm going to be playing the shit out of RWBY Grimm Eclipse until, well, forever, honestly.
That did not sound good.
Crescendo, holy crap. That was loud. Actually, there's a game I do need to get back to streaming that's not... Well, it's on my PC, but it's just because it's an emulator slash ROM setup. I get back into Xenoblade Chronicles for the Wii.
Dude, I got Xenoblade Chronicles for both the Wii and the 3DS.
I have it for the 3DS. I decided to download it on the Wii because that's... or on my PC because that's the only way I can stream it. I don't have a capture card for any of my systems whatsoever. So I got the Dolphin emulator so that I can play GameCube and Wii games. And hopefully I can, I need to get back into streaming that game because I have a save file that I started that I'm basically uploading to YouTube. Every time I stream the game, I upload it 15-minute parts on YouTube, so...
Also, I kind of hopped on the hype train a little bit, and kind of bought the, Xenoblade Chronicle X.
I'm not so hyped for... I wasn't so hyped for that game, and I still haven't decided if I want to buy it or not. And the only reason is because... It seems more long range than the original Xenoblade, and I don't really like that.
Well, the thing is, you can actually build your character long range, medium range, or melee range.
I prefer melee range because that's what Shulk was in Xenoblade.
They actually have Shulk's voice clip in it too.
Oh, that's awesome.
Isn't that the exact one? I think it's a little bit deeper voiced a little bit. Just like if Shulk aged like maybe 4 years, maybe.
Well, that's cool, at least.
So yeah, I even had the voice clip. I'm really feeling it.
That's amazing. I need that. If I get that game, I need to play as that.
Now are you on to the hype train?
I'm not on to the hype train yet. I have to. I honestly need money for the game, and I don't have money for the game, so that's the other problem.
And also, supposedly, you can also play online up to 4 players.
Well, that would be a reason to convince my friend to buy it as well.
But yeah, there's actually separate stats. There's melee base type, so it upgrades your melee and
I just know damage. That all the trailers showed off all the long range gameplay. I'm like, ew.
Well, also there's
because then like, they well, continue. Sorry, I do that a lot. I'm sorry.
There's like voice clips where if they say a certain thing, you do a percentage amount of extra damage or something like that.
Okay.
So, oh hey, we're just talking about Xenoblade Chronicle X. Don't mind us. But if they say like they say a certain line, you can deal up to 100% more damage if you do melee, or 200%. But they can also say something where shoot it from afar, you deal bonus damage for shooting from long range. That so this sense. Actually is. So there's actually bonuses for doing melee and range. There's even voice clips that allow you to heal your whole party and such like that.
That's a bit like, that's overdoing the game, holy crap.
It's just a lot of detail in it, and trust me, the I've yet to even hop into a skele yet, which is those mech things. I've killed three of the named mobs, the special mobs. Holy shit, the battles are amazing!
Wait, I can select four pins now? Holy shit, okay. Start with potions, health from orbs. What is this? Critical chance, yeah. Rampage gains, extra damage.
I could maybe stream it, but my internet's shit, so I can't.
Really, Yang? You had to steal my kill. I basically did all the damage on an Ursa, and Yang just walks up and steals my kill. It's like, really?
Yeah, see, that's what they need to change with the way experience works in RWBY, is because it's like, you don't want to be competing for last hits. Right. You know what I mean? Like, it's a hack and slash. You want to... It's a cooperative playstyle. It's not meant to be competitive.
Right. So, like, they should have it set up to where... As long as you've done... Like, if you've done it... It should be based on how much damage you've done to it. So, like... Oh, yeah, you definitely. If you've done, like, 100 damage to a particular creature, you get, like... let's say... each 100 gives you 10 EXP, so...
Okay, apparently I have Walk Must Die too.
So if you do 100 damage to one Grimm, you get 10 EXP. If you do 200 to it, you get 200, so on and so forth. Or 20, sorry, not 200. That'd be a little over excessive on EXP. Yeah, every 100 damage, you get 10 EXP or something. That'd be a little more fair.
Last night you dreamed about a big snake. It was Damballa, he whispered. But you couldn't understand him. Find his shrine to learn why he appeared in your dream. Fuck. Thunderstruck. Hey, oh, anyway. AC/DC, how I love you.
Endemic.
Yo, what's good, man?
Have you tried or looked at Orion Prelude? Orion?
Orion Prelude. It sounds familiar. I might have it in my Steam library.
I'm looking at it right now. You have 0 hours into it. Or 0 minutes.
Yeah, it's probably something that I ended up getting from a bundle or something that I just haven't put any hours into. Honestly, I don't even know what it's about.
It's an,
the names sound familiar, but that's about it.
It's an FPS dino survival game. Instead of fighting zombies, it's dinos.
Oh, okay. Interesting.
So something I guess I brought up earlier during when you were playing RWBY, and I guess would be interesting to bring up. I think they may have taken out the fence that I got stuck in.
Wait, they may have taken out what?
In RWBY, there was an area that I got stuck in, and I think they may have taken out the ability to get stuck there. Like, they may have actually taken out the object that I got stuck behind.
Huh, interesting.
Yeah, because there was a fence that I got stuck behind that was in an alleyway, and it looks like they've taken it completely out. Because I can't find it anywhere.
That would have been a very quick... That's a quick fix, then.
Yeah. That or it's happened to so many other people, and so many other people were complaining about it.
They might not even have taken it out. They could have just put up, like, an invisible wall or something as a temporary solution. Or are you saying, like, the entire, like, portion of the area is gone?
Well, just that particular fence seems to be gone. As in, like, the graphic for the fence doesn't even show up anymore.
Huh, interesting.
Meaning, I just can't... If I could find it, maybe I may be looking in the wrong spot, too, so who knows.
You might be in the wrong spot, possibly, because... You know how the game gives you, like, alternate plays each time you go through it? Like, right. Alternate paths?
Right.
It could have been on the other path. Possibly. I'm not saying that that's the case, but...
Well, now you're saying that after I had to prove you wrong?
Honestly, I never noticed it before until you said something. I don't even know what I just picked. Oh, it's a fire wand. Okay. Oh, this thing wrecks. Too bad it's only limited use. I'm playing this level in full mode with Rampage right now. There's these fucking, like, skeleton conga line mobs.
Yeah, I'm watching.
Oh my god. It's fucking brutal, man.
You just kind of say nope.
Yes, I got all the HP for that dire freaking Ursa.
Nice. Are you talking about the boss one before the tower falls?
Yeah, right before the tower falls. I got all the HP for it.
How much does that one give? Like 80?
100.
Oh!
So it's relic.
Oh, man. Craigasm.
I may actually hit level 10 with Blake this time around. I joined a random game halfway through because I was like, you know, that might be the best way to do it.
Oh, thank goodness. Oh man, I thought I was going the right way to get through this level. I ended up going in a giant circle.
Yeah.
Oh, kamikaze, please.
Oh shit.
Life flashed before my eyes.
I'm actually looking through your games.
Yeah, I've got a bunch, but if there's anything you want to see in particular, Dorks, let me know. I don't mind streaming if it's content people want to see.
Let's see.
Let's start looking for a way out.
Shit.
See, I need about 800 to level 9.
Because I'd rather stream content that people want to see than just what I want to play, because if there's something in particular that I want to play, I can always do it on my own time. Oh
my god, that's a stupid game.
What's a stupid game?
South Park and the Stick of Truth.
Dude, that game is fucking hilarious. What are you talking about?
You're so stupid.
No way, dude. That game is gold. I can't wait for the next one to come out. Oh my god, I need a potion so bad. Summon. Help me, Sumedi.
I never actually watched South Park, and fuck, I'm glad I did.
Dude, you've never seen South Park? That's probably why you don't like the game.
I mean, I've like seen and like know what it is, but it's so dumb.
You have to like something first in order for you to like a game about it.
Yeah, because like if you don't like the content of the actual game, like of what it's based on, you're probably not gonna enjoy it.
Okay.
Oh, fucking bomb.
I understand Crescendo is overpowered, but you have to spam it 5 times in a row. Holy crap.
Well, I mean, when it's that strong, the answer is definitely yes.
Because literally, I heard this person playing RWBY, and it's just like, okay, Crescendo, 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 Crescendo. I literally heard the sound effect for it 5 times in a row. It doesn't help that there's 2 RWBYs in this game, so...
Dude, I'm talking to, like, the snake god in this game right now, and he's like, maybe you're still asleep. He's like, no, and my character's saying, no, I don't think so. In my dreams, there are always big parties and lots of women. So far, I've only seen zombies and skeleton warriors. Snake god's like, good point. Oh, man. His name is Uru, and I want you to take care of him. His power resides on his acolytes, so it might be necessary for you to take care of them before Okay. Do this task, and I will help you in the future. Bro, why don't you help me now? I have 18 health and no potions. I got wrecked on this level.
As you suck.
Dude, I'm super bad.
There we go.
Mala told me that I must defeat the great Uru that is bringing chaos to the world. He is too powerful for me at this time, so it might be a good idea to defeat his acolytes first. I ain't even been mad about it, son. Okay, none of these are like shops or anything. These are all different bosses. Voodoo the Unholy. Baba Bumba, the unhappy. Find the seal, summon the acolyte, and destroy him.
Is this game multiplayer?
Which one? Full Mojo Rampage?
Yeah.
Yes, it is. Up to 4 player co-op. It's fun. The first, like, area, the first level, tends to be pretty easy, but once you get to, like, the second and third, it ramps up pretty quickly.
Because I think I've seen a friend play this once before, and I think he was doing the survival run.
Oh, yeah.
Where you try to survive, and then the next level, you survive,
I died. Now I gotta start this level over. Fuck.
And you bad.
Ah, dude. Ah, still bad, so sad.
I think you would be terrible at Binding of Isaac.
Who, me?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm not too bad. Or I'm not too good, I mean. Looking.
I'm pretty all right.
I've put in a decent amount of hours into that game, but...
I got good hand-eye coordination.
It's not a matter of hand-eye coordination for me. It's just getting surrounded by too many dudes.
I don't think
quick enough on my feet.
I've played Black Ops Zombie since I was like 12. I'm like 19.
Playing what?
Black Ops Zombies and just get.
Gross. Call of Duty. Dorks,
hey, I've only played zombie for it.
I was gonna say, dorks,
please.
I can at least accept that the
multiplayer is shit to me. To me, it's just like, okay, it's there. Okay.
If you're gonna tell somebody not to play Call of Duty, don't rip on them for playing zombies. Zombies is an acceptable reason to play Call of Duty.
That's true, but I mean, I wouldn't pay $60 just for.
Some people will, and it's hilarious why.
Fuck, I found a mojo mixer, but I don't have any relics to fuse. Pissed.
Damn, box break.
Alright, let's not get down to 18 health before.
There's no food left in the car. Hurry, gather those dust crystals.
I think I might switch out one of my pins for the damage pin, though. Oh, kamikaze, please.
Oh, I'm not cutting this time, come on.
Special mojo. Your damage is increased when you kill four elites. I wonder if that's permanent or if that's just like a temporary solution. Oh shit! No, no, Bomberman! No, Bomberman! Oh my god!
In general, I've been playing games since I was probably 7 or 8.
I think the first time I ever touched a video game, I think I was about 2.5 or 3.
I probably was I'm probably much younger, but the first time I owned a game system of my own was 11.
I think my first game system was a PS1. No.
Like, my family always owned game systems.
No, go ahead.
Sorry, my family's always owned game systems ever since I was young, but, like, they weren't mine. The first time I technically had my own system or something to play games on of my own was a freaking Game Boy Advance SP when I was 11.
My very first console that was my own was... Damn it, I died again. Was, let me see. It was the original Nintendo that my dad had given to me. And after that, I got a Sega Genesis. I never bought a Super Nintendo because like three of my neighbors had it, so I was playing at their houses. And after Sega Genesis, I bought a N64. There, I... as well as a GameCube, and then I had a PS2, then I had a Wii U, and then I had an Xbox 360. Those were all the consoles I owned growing up.
I believe my first couple of consoles was a Super Nintendo, a Nintendo 64, then I believe a PS1, then a PS2. I think those were my first couple of systems.
Yeah, I know a lot of my friends, how do I shoot this? No! It's like something blocking my path here. I don't... Oh, there we go. A lot of my buddies had PlayStations like you growing up. That's why they're all, like, heavy Final Fantasy fanatics.
See, I didn't have a Final... I never... Well, okay, I had a PlayStation 1 growing up, but I didn't have Final Fantasy, like, anything.
The only place I ever played Final Fantasy was on GameCube. Or not on GameCube, sorry. On, what were those things called? Game Boys.
Oh, yeah.
Have you guys ever
Final
heard
Fantasy
of a...
on Game Boy, but that was it.
See, I'm... But that's what's really nice is that I'm now playing...
Hold on a second.
I'm now doing a playthrough of Final Fantasy VII on Steam. I bought Final Fantasy VII on Steam and decided to play through it.
Have you ever heard of a PS2 series called Tasmanian Tiger?
I don't know too much about it though. I've heard about it though.
I played both 1, 2, and 3.
Okay.
I loved that game.
Well, I know who to blame for not getting to level 10, and it's my experience hogging teammates that don't. I need to play with friends in order to get things done in this game.
Why don't you just do a solo playthrough?
I guess I could do that. That probably would work.
Yeah.
I mean, if you want to wait, I'll hop in and help you later, but I want to take a break from RWBY because I've played it for so long.
That's fine. I'm probably just going to do a solo playthrough, but I'm about to hop off of anything. I'm just going to go take a break really quick, so I'll be right back.
All right.
It's only 10:30 and I'm tired.
Okay. Yeah, it's kind of felt one of those days where it feels a lot later than it actually is. Like, it's only 8:30 over here, and it feels like it's at least midnight, maybe 1.
Yeah, I know how those feel.
especially being a hardcore gamer. Like, all I do 24/7 pretty much is games. Like, games are literally my life.
Dude, game's number one, man.
Also, do you have a dream team for Pokemon, by chance?
Oh, shit. Fuck, don't blow me up. Sorry, what were you asking?
If you could have 6 Pokemon in real life, what would they be?
That's a tough one, man.
I already know my 6. And I even made that team in Pokemon Omega Ruby.
Bulbasaur, Charmander, Squirtle, Mew, Articuno, and I don't know about a 6.
Okay, let me rephrase. 6 Pokemon that you wish that would you had in real life that's not legendaries.
That's not legendaries. Come on, man. You got to clarify that beforehand, because now I'm just gonna, regardless of what I pick.
Honestly, I don't.
All right, here you go. Charmander, Charmeleon, Charizard, Squirtle, fucking, what's his name?
Wartortle,
Blastoise, and fucking Bulbasaur, Ivysaur, and Venusaur.
Nope, that's 9.
Oh, that is 9. You're right. I can't count. I fail.
What are you trying to count now?
I'm done. I give up. I fail at math. I give up. I'm flipping the table and walking away.
Okay, I'm back.
You just kind of missed it.
Fucking flip the table, walk away, dude.
I asked him what 6 non-legendaries he would want. And
okay, let's clarify.
Nine.
Before that, you had asked me any. Oh, fuck. Dude, these stupid skeletons with their Congo lines are kicking my ass. And then these. Oh, my God. And these bomb guys. This level, I just can't.
But yeah, my 6 Pokemon non-legendaries is in their final forms, Typhlosion.
What the fuck is a Typhlosion? That's not an original 150. Get out of here.
Okay, nope. Gen 1er, stop talking. What the fuck?
Let's be real. If it's not original 150, it doesn't count.
I actually have the original 150 Pokemon puzzle.
Dude, I still have the OG original 150 Pokemon Pokedex toy from when I was like 10.
I think I may have it somewhere.
Nice work, students.
I think it's just been sitting in my closet.
Having some trouble with the security network in this area.
Dude, I even bought these like bouncy balls, but they're like Pokeballs. I bought 8 of them just because they came in a pack of 4.
Dude, you guys remember when Burger King had those like those Pokeballs, and you open them up and they had like a golden like card inside?
Yeah.
There's like Pikachu, Mewtwo, all that shit.
No.
Wasn't it?
Yeah, I remember.
I just don't remember.
I remember.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Oh my God. Oh my God. Please, game. Don't do this to me.
Don't be bad.
Dude, I'm trying not to, but I'm horrible at roguelike games like this.
See, if we're gonna talk about how, like, if we're just gonna talk about favorite Pokemon stuff, my favorite Pokemon set is the 3rd generation, so I'm definitely not a Gen 1-er.
Dude,
I can't.
Gen 1 is all that mattered. Oh, what is that? Okay, so
What is Jodo?
Reflect all the incoming damage.
Jodo is Gen 2.
And I'm Jodo. And then Gen 2.
I'm a Gen 3 person. I like Hoenn.
Gen 3 was Crystal and Sapphire, right?
Ruby and Sapphire.
Or Ruby Sapphire, yeah.
Let's see.
Wouldn't you hear something funny I did in Pokemon Ruby?
What?
I've gotten... Okay, from the very beginning of the game to the Elite Four, I really only use three Pokemon.
Another enemy.
I've done it with one, so not that hard, actually.
The three Pokemon I used was Slaking, Gardevoir, and Combusken.
You didn't evolve it?
Oh my god.
And not, whatever the...
Blaziken.
Guys, this is my nightmare.
You only make me a little upset with that, because Blaziken is by far my favorite Pokemon.
Blaziken! That's
Blaziken is my favorite Pokemon of all time.
Oh my god. Guys, please, this level is my nightmare. It's nothing but spiders. Oh my god. And they're kicking my ass.
You're talking about spirit spiders? The first time I played Minecraft, I had a hard time with spiders. I was like, oh god, no. There's spiders in this game, I don't think I can play it.
This game.
Dude, my friend is just...
It's gonna be the end of
he does not like spiders. In-game or out. Not spiders, but snakes.
Snakes on a Plane is his favorite movie? Is that what you're saying?
I was gonna say, you should watch the movie Eight-Legged Freaks.
Oh, fuck that, dude. I'll never watch that movie. Actually, I might have seen that movie. That's probably the movie that gave me arachnophobia, now that I think about it.
That's probably how it was for me. I was going to say, I remember I watched it because I was at my aunt's house and there's nothing else on television. That's what she put on. I was like, are you serious? And from there on, I think I've just been afraid of spiders.
But yeah, my friend just hates snakes.
I mean, like,
I'm cool, like,
what about WoW?
In World of Warcraft, in Draenor, there's this, like, lake of snakes, apparently. I had to go in there, kill all the snakes for him. He would not go into the water because there were snakes. And he had to keep his screen facing away from the snakes to get an item.
Oh, jeez.
Like, he does not like snakes.
And, like, I'm cool at looking at snakes and stuff as long as they're, you know, at a safe distance. But I'll never, like, hold one or get close to one or anything like that.
Dude, one of my friends has a pet snake.
Oh, fuck that. See, I can just imagine, like, I would go to pick up... If I had a pet snake, like, I'd go to pick it up and, like, oh, cool, hang out with me. Little sneaky, and then it just sinks its giant ass fangs into my arm. Like, no, thank you.
Let's get this artifact. That
apparently, the snake had an egg in their house, so 9-2. So yeah, he likes snakes.
I, know, so I just keep thinking of that Temple of Doom movie of Indiana Jones where they like cut open that giant snake and they start eating like little babies that crawl out of its fucking belly.
Okay, how did that work? I forgot how this worked. Is it this way?
Oh no! I'm gonna die again.
Here it is.
Why are you so bad at games?
Dude, I'm usually not this bad at games, but...
There it is.
You ran right into that suicide bomb.
You saw nothing, dorks. You saw nothing.
I definitely saw it.
Crap. I think I got Nope. No, I'm not stuck. Cool.
I most definitely
did. Oh, that's a wand right there.
It.
Oh, my.
Like, why is this here, though? Holy crap.
This game is going to be the end of me.
How long will it take you to download Borderlands 2?
Borderlands 2? I don't know. Let me see. How big is it of a file?
It's decently sized.
I am literally just exploring the...
Let me go check the store page.
Now that you've shown me how to get outside of the map, kind of, I'm now just exploring the outside of the map.
That's just like all you're gonna do now.
Never show me how to break a game.
Oh yeah, it's like 13 gigs. It'll probably take me, I don't know, at least 30 minutes, probably.
That's not so bad. It's a lot shorter than it'll take me to download it. It'll take me probably about an hour to two.
My fucking headset's doing that thing again.
Alright, let's see, how do I get back out of here?
Oh,
right this way,
right? Good question. Why don't you go try jumping off that cliff, see what happens?
Nope, I figured it out. I don't want to lose my experience, fuck that.
Just pull an endemic and fall through the floor for 20 minutes on end.
The only reason I went outside of the map was to get that extra artifact that's there for no reason. Like, how do they... That's the question. They put it there. How do they expect people to actually find that?
I don't know. I watched somebody get it. I'm like, huh?
I don't think you're technically supposed to, like, go up there. I think it's an area that might be still in development that they have plans for.
Right.
You know, because I don't think they expect people to actually try to, like, jump up the wall. You know?
But the fact that it's possible is like, wait. So, do you want us to get it, or do you not want us to get it? Because if you didn't want us to get it, you'd make it impossible to get up there.
Yeah, exactly. Oh, man. I could play Titan Souls right now, but...
What games do you have downloaded? Risk of Rain downloaded.
Let's see. Who all has Tabletop Sim? Cody, Vince. Oh, Matthew has it. Interesting.
Do you know on how to host a Risk of Rain server?
I didn't even know Risk of Rain was multiplayer. I thought it was only single player.
No, it's multi.
Huh. Interesting.
It's a bit of a pain in the ass to get the multi, but it's multi.
If I have to like download third-party software and like start a server like Minecraft, I'm gonna pass.
You do gotta host a server like Minecraft, but that's about it.
Well, like, is it the same setup? Like, you have to go and download an extra piece of software?
No. You just got, if you know on how to port forward, that's pretty about it. That's about it.
For though. Minecraft, like, you have to go to the website and download a server if you want to start a server.
Yeah, server.exe, yeah. I know.
I mean, I have, like, four or five servers for Minecraft downloaded. I'm just like... Oh my god, Austin, why? Why'd you do this?
Let's see here.
Alright, well, looks like I have to get
home. Oh god, fucking... Super Bounce is doing a,
What about Sanctum 2?
Trunk thing. Jeez.
Oh, when you die, do all of the freaking artifacts respawn?
Well, when you die, you get reset back to, like, a checkpoint, so it just resets everything that happened, after you hit that checkpoint.
Because, like, it's hard to tell with this particular one. When you die right before the, control center in the cave, well, if you get the checkpoint right before then, does it, like, what do they consider before that? Also, you can't go backwards, so that's weird. You'd think you'd be able to go backwards, but you cannot. Yeah, once you reach a certain checkpoint, apparently you can't go backwards.
I know that, like, you can't go backwards once you, like, jump down the cliff parts and stuff, because obviously you can't jump that high, but...
But, like, when I
die... You should be able to go back to a certain extent.
Like, you know those rocks that you break out of the way once you get to unlock the area where the cave is? They're back where they were.
Hmm.
I can't go back any further.
Is Rivals of Ethel, Ethel free?
I don't know if it's free, I'm not sure, but... Honestly, if you're gonna play that game, you might as well play the game it's based off of.
Smash, I know. Yeah, it's $15.
I was gonna say, if you're gonna play that game, it's not worth, if you're gonna buy it, it's not worth, I don't think it's worth the time to buy it. Shovel Knight. I should play that game, but I don't have the time or money.
Shovel Knight's absolutely great.
The only thing about Shovel Knight I don't like is everyone who says he should be in Smash Brothers. I'm sorry. He does not deserve to be in Smash Brothers.
Who, Cloud?
No, Smash, or Shovel Knight.
Shovel Knight, why would Shovel Knight ever be in Smash Brothers?
They were talking about how there's the Smash ballot and people, you have the ability to vote for someone to be in Smash Brothers. Well, people were apparently voting for Shovel Knight.
I mean, that'd be interesting to see, but... I mean, I'm not for it, but I wouldn't be against it if he ended in there.
Honestly, I don't even know why Ryu is in Smash.
Capcom. That's literally the answer to that question.
Well, yeah. I mean, Cloud's being released on Smash soon, and everybody knows that's all that matters.
I don't even know why that's either.
Everybody knows that that is all that matters, and no one's going to play anybody else except for Cloud.
No, I'm not gonna play. I'm gonna play Cloud, but I'm not gonna just say, "Oh, he's the only character that matters." I'm still gonna keep my main. My main's Ike.
I'm a Luigi.
Oh, you're a fucking Ike. God damn, I hate you.
I'm a Luigi.
I hate Ike players.
Why?
Because that he is super tanky, he hits super hard, and that stupid ass counter ability drives me insane.
You could say, well, besides the fact that he's super strong and heavy, the only thing I think that's a little unfair is the fact that he has the counter. Counters in general are what I think are a little broken in the game. Sure, I use it, but I don't use it all that often, actually. I use it as a last ditch effort if I think I'm gonna lose.
I only use it if the opponent's being annoying and just, like, kind of just being a dick. Like, no! Stop that! I mean, I'm not the Pikachu Thunderbolt spammer.
Oh god, Pikachu Thunderbolt spam. My buddy does that. But, I'm gonna take a quick peek here.
I only use it when that, like, at the top of the screen, just for that spike up. But I don't like spike spam up it.
I mean, who's your main Epidemic?
My main fucking Sonic for days, man.
See, I understand why you like. I can understand why you'd like Sonic, and I definitely like Sonic, probably for the same reason. But
gotta go fast.
There are people who will say Sonic's a more annoying character than Ike, and honestly, I agree with those people.
Oh, he is. Oh, he hands down is. But when you're playing as Sonic, Ike will, like, two-shot you.
Yeah,
that's why I hate Ike so much.
If you let him, yes, he will two-shot you, but a good Sonic player is too fast for that.
In Smash, my mains are Ike, Luigi, and a little bit of King Dedede, a little bit.
I have to say, mine are right now. I'm really good with Ike and Palutena.
Cool, Captain Falcon too.
We're talking about the new one. I was talking about Smash itself for the Wii.
Yeah, I'm talking about Smash for the Wii U at least.
Well, for the Wii U, it's the Luigi and a little bit of Captain Falcon.
For me, it's Ike and Lady Palutena.
Lady Palutena is so unpredictable.
She's also very laggy, though, so, like her moves are very easy to punish if you know how to. That's the only bad part about her.
Yeah, but if you don't know her very well and haven't fought against her that much, she is very, very unpredictable.
Well, in the scene that I like to play Smash Brothers in, if you haven't played against every character at least once, then I don't know what's wrong with you. But that's just the people I play with a lot. If it's like people I've just started talking to, I don't blame you if you haven't played the game.
I'm gonna take a quick break. I'm gonna go grab some dinner real quick. I'm getting kind of hungry. I haven't eaten since about, probably 1 o'clock. But yeah, I'll check back in Discord. I'll see if you guys are around when I get back.
We probably will be. Who knows? We're
almost. All right. Sounds good. Take care, guys.
All right. You too.
So what game? The games that you have. Well, oh wait, I don't have you on my list.
You should add me if you want. I'm ostentatious.
Austin.
TATIOUS.
Is this the same as your? Yeah.
If it was the same as my stream name, then it would be GX Holified, but it is not.
Austin.
Yeah. Send me an invite. Me and you can play some stuff together. I honestly, it doesn't matter to me. As long as I have it, obviously. If I don't have it, I can't play it, obviously. I don't have money just to buy things right now.
Is your thing the Jack is this with Blake on it?
Yeah. That would be me.
Oh, the fuck is this?
The fuck is this?
What games you got? You got TF2, Left 4 Dead 2.
I love Left 4 Dead 2. I need people to play with.
Yeah, I kind of like it. It's kind of meh.
It can get boring and repetitive. Yeah. But I like it.
Hey, have you ever heard of a YouTuber named Scott Bay?
I don't think so, no.
He is stupid funny. The security network in this region is. He does Skyrim. He does Skyrim, Left 4 Dead 2, and Planetside 2. And he just recently started Fallout 4.
Let's see, Steam. Yeah, I've got some interesting games on my in my library. Some of which,
interesting.
Some of them you made.
I am bread.
Yeah, I have. I am bread. Some of them you just don't ask why I have them. I just have them.
Like Sakura Spirit.
Yes, and Nekopara Volume 1. Don't ask why I have them, I just do. Because people want me to play through them, and it's like, god damn it, fine, I'll do it.
And I'll hate you for it.
I'll hate myself for it.
I will kill you in your sleep, you just don't know when.
I actually need to do a stream or a full let's play of I Am Bread, because that game is so stupid.
Do you want to do some TF2?
I mean, I guess in a bit here. Let me look.
just lets you know, I am going to be Demo Knight.
I am probably going to be playing Engineer. I haven't played the game in forever, so another security network in need of repair. It'll be fun for me to get used to the controls again. Clues about who did this.
We're all counting on you. I'm just letting you know, I'm gonna be Demo Knight.
I may also play Heavy.
This is coming with us. Dude, you wanna hear something funny?
What?
That happened once? Okay, so I was playing Demo Knight on a Capital Point map, okay?
Okay.
Also, my team was idiots. I was the best player on the team. But what happened was, I'm like, okay, I need to stop. But what happened was, I went behind enemy lines by killing one of the guys and dashing behind him.
Right.
And I had like 5 people follow me back to the spawn. And I killed multiple of them before I went down.
Okay.
I'm like, okay, I need to stop.
These are more dangerous than the Grimm you fought before. When it sees you, it will spin before it charges.
So it's like, okay, what am I doing? Why is this working? Why am I not dead? Like, that question kept going through my mind, like, how am I not dead?
Like, right now, the only game I've really been playing is Grimm Eclipse, because best game on my library right now.
What, this, the RWBY?
Yeah, it's the only game I've been enjoying recently.
Yeah.
Besides things I have in my other, like, systems. I love PC, and I know, I recognize PC Master Race, but I actually don't play as much PC as I should to be considered a PC Master Race member. Like, most people are like, wait, how, you support the PC Master Race, yet you don't play PC all that often. What the hell is wrong with you? Honestly, it's just because I don't have time to. Most of the times, if I'm playing games, I'm on the go.
Hey, are you into MMOs?
Kind of, depends on what they are.
I have a quest.
I have not played that one.
Cause I'm just looking for more people to play with. Cause it's a lot of fun. It's a lot of fun with other people. Cause you can actually have a group of 6 people in the same group. And it's one of those games that's not super forgiving. Back in the day, it was super unforgiving. But nowadays, it's a bit more forgiving, but it's kind of meh still. Like, when you die, you have a chance of losing your level.
Alright, right now I'm trying to take out these fucking boar Grimm, so.
Mm-hmm.
Where are the rest of. Oh, there he is.
And back in the day, not only would you die, you would lose some of your experience. But you also have to go fetch your corpse to re-get your gear.
Please don't kill me, oh my god, oh my god. Regain my aura, there we go. I'm trying my hardest to get Blake to level 10 right now.
Mm-hmm.
And doing a solo playthrough is not as easy as it sounds.
Oh, I know, I've done it. As RWBY, and it still was hard.
Alright, where'd he go? There we go. He died. Well, at least I can go back that way. That's random and unneeded, honestly. But whatever. There are so many places in this game that you think there would be an artifact, but there's nothing. It's like, why would you put so much work into putting this here if there's not going to be an artifact there? Like, RT, please. Like, and it's the thing that's really good about this game, though, is the fact that even though we're noticing problems that they need to fix, we're still okay with what we have.
Yeah.
Which means they can only go up from here.
I know it's a stretch, but maybe. Maybe you operate that mechanism to extend the bridge. Ah, it worked! And seemed to attract some Grimm. Happy hunting!
Alright, let's see if I can get this going, because... Yeah, once I'm done, I wouldn't mind hopping on some TF2 for a bit.
Have you ever done Man vs. Machine?
Yes, I love Man vs. Machine.
It's like zombies to me. So much fun. Especially when you find a x10 server with it.
Oh god, okay, I've never actually been on a x10 server, but... yeah, I've heard about those, and I...
Oh, they're so much fun!
See, if you're looking for someone who wants to play TF2 more often, like all the time, I have a friend who plays it almost daily.
Dude, x10 Mega Bazooka.
Okay, so you can't talk to me too much about TF2 stuff, because let's be honest, the only thing in TF2 that the only game mode I usually play on TF2 besides Man vs. Machine is, what's it called? Basically, you're supposed to get your cart to the other end of the map.
Oh, payload.
Yeah, I play payload most of the time.
Well, Mega Bazooka is a weapon.
Oh, see. For what? For Demonite, that's why.
No, Soldier.
Oh, and then still, I don't play that class either.
Okay, x10,
The only thing I know about Soldier really well is Market Gardening.
What is that one? What's that one weapon that makes your hand mechanical?
For the engineer?
Yeah.
Oh, crap, what's it called? I forgot.
It allows you to make a mini sentry.
I know, I'm trying to think of what it's called. I don't know the name off the top of my head, but, I know I have the weapon, so I'll...
Yeah, me too.
I'll look at it when I look.
One less monster.
Gunslinger.
Oh yeah, Gunslinger, thank you. Gunslinger Engineer, that's what I like to play.
Gunslinger Engineer, 450 health. Can you imagine that?
Yep.
What about the kunai spy? The most hated thing on a x10 server.
No. See, the one thing that I know a lot of people hate is the, what is it with the spy? Fuck, I forgot what it was called. I guess there's a reason for it, though. I haven't played TF2 in forever, so...
Describe it.
It's an icicle.
The Spicicle.
Is it really just called the Spicicle?
Yes. No joke.
I forgot. There's so much about TF2 I'm trying to remember off the top of my head, and I'm probably getting it completely wrong. That's why I'm not saying anything. Because I know if I say something, I'm going to sound stupid.
But you want to know why the kunai spy is the worst on x10 server?
Why?
First off...
Oh, your eternal reward, that's what it's called. Not thinking of...
Eternal reward.
Your eternal reward.
Oh, yeah, so that's not that bad. Just a normal knife.
Is it really
just the allows? It, the only downside to it is the spies can't cloak. They have to get a backstab to be able to cloak. That's the only downside to that. So it's just kind of meh.
Depends on how you play the class.
Yeah. But the reason why kunai spies are the most hated on times 10... One, they start off at one health, which no biggie, right? One health. If they get a single backstab, they will have 2,000 health.
See, that's a little overdoing it.
Yeah, kunai spies, everyone.
Let's see. Even with all the experience, I don't know if I'll be able to make level 10. Unless there's an artifact I'm missing, and that's the problem. I don't... Pretty sure I'm not missing any. There's a strategy that one of my friends wanted to try out with me that might work for getting people to level 10. And it's having a group of friends where one person will consistently just die over and over again, and you get EXP for reviving them.
What's this thing?
Then again, I am at level 6 near the end of Emerald Forest, so I might reach level 10. By the end of Mountain Glen. It's a long shot, but who knows. Then again, I'm about to reach level 7, so... I have to get through all of level 7 and 8 and 9.
Just as I thought, more sabotage from our friend with the symbol. Those
coolies. Yes, but who is our friend?
To capture Grimm? Don't like the looks of this. For now, let's just focus on the objective. Defend that control center while I undo the damage. Get ready!
Alright, let's see. Okay. I didn't realize he had hosted my room for 2 viewers. Thank you. I need to pay attention to my stream chat more often, especially when I'm streaming, but crap, I didn't realize I wasn't paying attention to my stream chat. I forgot I was streaming. Yeah, Epidemic hosted me.
Students, we're a quarter of the way there. Keep up the good work.
Yeah, I'm sorry. Yes, thanks for the host. That's a first actually for me, is getting someone to host me.
Halfway point, team.
All right, level 7 will do. Plague of Frenzy. There is one thing that does help with playing multiple people in this game is when you get wave MVP. That is free experience. Yeah.
Hold on just a little longer. We're almost finished.
Oh, I know that feeling. By the way, that moment when food gets stuck in your mustache. I don't know it as well, maybe, because, like, you know, it's... Mine's not probably not as thick as others is, but I've had it happen still. Like I said, it's not much of a beard, I have facial hair and I'm growing it.
It's an old research and development corporation, far before your time. The company was crippled by the collapse of Mountain Glen, where they lost their primary facility and chief staff members. They never recovered from the incident and eventually shut down. Which begs the question, why is their technology suddenly popping up in the Emerald Forest? I've never been one for riddles and history. More of a man of action, if I do say so myself. But I think I know someone who can help. Onward! To victory!
Dang, man, you're slacking. Zero score, zero kills, zero deaths. What the hell?
Or it might be everything. Either way, I believe it should be worth investigating the Below Industries building in Mountain Glen. If my old maps are still accurate, it should be located somewhere near the center. Just do your best not to end up like the RWBY. Great. Mountain Glen. Again.
Just here for the scenery, huh?
Thank you.
Even though I'm not very good at talking to my chat and reading my chat is because I don't usually have one to talk to. Most of the time, anybody who's in my chat is very far and very far and few. But I'm I get it, the scenery, her skirt, I get it. It was funny. I just know I'm... It's 12:30 around where I'm at, so it's past midnight. So, I'm just getting tired.
Hope it still works. It looks a little rusty.
I need exactly 15 to get to level 8. Yeah, true. I try to talk as much as possible while I'm playing, so...
Let's do this.
It's not easy when people... Well, when you're not used to it. I have to get used to it. I don't stream all that often, so I need to do it more often. Also, it's easier to talk to your stream and such when you have people to talk to. Well, like actual people to talk to. Like, what I'm talking... Like Dorkly, who hasn't said a word since I don't know, actually. Now you're just laughing.
It's kind of funny. Don't you have dual screens?
Do I have dual screens? No, I have a single monitor.
You bad.
I have no choice. I don't have this. I don't have the money to get another thing. Nor do I have the cords to do it either.
Technically, my computer could probably go 3 screens, but I don't have the room on my desk.
I have the room for another desk or for another screen. I just don't have the desk. I have.
Because you need 2 desks for 1 monitor.
I have room for another monitor, it's just I don't have another monitor to, you know, do that with. Dang it, my combo keeps getting reset. There we go. I should be paying attention to the stream chat, and I'm not, and it's bad. Are you serious? They just cornered me, okay. They literally cornered me even though I was in the middle of using a special and I couldn't get out. That's a little shit. But okay, that happens occasionally.
Also, I tried adding you to my friends list, but it wasn't...
I didn't get a request, that's... I've never had this happen.
What?
Well, I've just, I went down and then, an endemic disconnected. So now I'm respawning in 5, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
So wait, is he back or something?
Like, I don't know if he's back in, like, well, he's definitely not in the chat, obviously, because he's not, he was minimized for too long, that's why he disconnected. All of a sudden, my game is lagging, see, what the heck. Let me, see, what is up with that? Why am I lagging so hard? I am lagging like really bad. Well, the stream is running on a different computer altogether. Remember, I'm watching the stream chat and stuff on my laptop while I'm playing the game on my desktop.
Something like I would do.
Then let me just close out my entire desk, my laptop, and see if that does it. My laptop. This game likes to freeze on me sometimes, though, so it happens all the time. Yeah. The game has crashed a couple times while I was streaming it, and it sucked so much. Turn off my laptop and turn it back, or not turn it back on, I'll probably just keep it off. Which means I can't pay attention to this chat for sure now. Unless I open it up on my desktop, which isn't going to help the problem I'm having right now. It might be because I'm not close enough to the Grimm, who knows.
Maybe.
That box. My OCD is getting to me. That's not a good thing. Never a good thing, actually.
Never good?
Never good to have OCD. Yeah, I think it was just because of how far away from the Grimm I was. Holy crap. It was trying to spawn all these Grimm that it... Usually this game doesn't like to... Doesn't have to spawn things so far away. So it's only used to run... Okay, I get it. I know why the game was lagging now. Had nothing to do with me. Well, it had to do with the fact that I spawned so far away from all the Grimm that were already spawned in. It's not used to have all this area spawned in all at once. That's just a technical limitation of this game, then. Stop fucking with this claw attack. Holy crap, that attack is annoying. Like, if I'm playing Yang, I don't care as much, because with Yang...
Yeah, he's like, oh, what's health? Oh, wait, I have special.
Yeah, with all that invincibility frame.
So you just about done now?
I am in the middle of... I'm still gonna have to do all of the bottom part of Mountain Glen. I'm at, I'm still at the, what's it called? The highway. I'm basically where they first introduced the Ursa. Where we're opening the door. I have a while to go. Single solo playthroughs are not easy,
especially as Blake.
Oh yeah, no, Blake doesn't make it. It doesn't make it any easier than I'm playing as Blake. Blake is only really useful when you're playing in a group. This Ursa is wrecking me. Holy crap! There we go.
The door is open.
Killed the Ursa. Blah blah blah. Hooray. Let's see where I can go from here. Need 125 to go to level 9. Yeah, I'll be able to do this. need 100 to get to. Level 9. Which means if I go ahead and, see where. Oh, no, I found the gate I got stuck in. I just wasn't looking hard enough.
Look harder! Stop slacking!
Well, I found it, so I did look harder.
Think about laying down for a little bit.
That's what I get for exploring. See, once I reach level 10, I'll probably just jump off of this and, well, I don't even have to finish the game. I'll just go to level 10 and I'll jump off. So, let's see. I'll just get to level 10 and jump off, that's what I'll do. Which won't take too long.
I can't believe how well it withstood the years. Shame, Steve. Dr. Malone would have never let something like this hinder the progress of his life.
It's time to reboot my laptop.
Watch out, team. The treasure hunt will have to wait until you kill those Grimm.
Going AFK during this game, not a good idea. Especially when you're playing by yourself. Like, just has one major problem. She can't build combo, because she gets hit out of it all the time.
Well, that's why she has a good long range, so you run away and just go pew 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 pew.
Yeah, but when they're all chasing you, when you have the entire pack chasing you, it's not as easy as it looks.
Not easy, but it's possible.
Thank you. see, that was stupid. That literally was stupid. I've seen that stuff happen to me way too much, where I get tripped. I try to do a special attack, and nope, I get hit by enemies like 6 or 7 times over. Let's see, where am I? That's the door. So I'm here. Okay. I freaking died. Now I'm back level 8. I have to do all that again. I know one thing, I'm never gonna be able to finish a solo playthrough. At least not on purpose. Level 9, I am 1,660 HP away. So I just need a lot of things. Let's see. Let's open up my stream again and see what's going on. Because obviously I need to be able to read the stream chat just in case people are watching. Let's increase Dora. There we go. Mute the stream so I can hear it. There we go. Okay. Stream's back up. Watching it. I see this chat. Bing, bang, bada boom. Bada bing, bada boom. I don't know. I am literally tired and bored right now. Which is why I think some TF2 will be enjoyable once I reach level 10.
There! That's the facility! I can't believe how well it withstood the years. It seems to me. Someone alone would have never let something like this.
Oh.
Watch out, team! The treasure hunt will have to wait until you kill those Grimm!
I'm gonna lay down in bed for a little bit. Luckily, I have wireless headset, so I can lay down in bed and talk. Oh, why?
Wait, what? I thought you said you were gonna lay down in bed. I thought you were leaving. Sorry.
Like I said, I have wireless headset, so I can lay down and talk.
You just made it sound like when you say when people say they're going to lay down in bed, it usually means they're getting offline or they're going somewhere and I can't.
Hey, it's just more the fact that my left leg is kind of acting up right now. But just have to stretch it. You know that feeling when you sit too long and it kind of tight and...
Yep. I know what you mean.
Yeah, that's kind of what's happening in my left leg right now.
There's some things. I see, this is why I can't stream for too long sometimes, because guess what ends up happening? I pay no attention to the friends I normally pay a ton of attention to, and they're wondering, hey Austin, can you do this for me or this for me? I'm like, crap. This is why I should be checking my phone every 10 minutes. Cause I get so many missed messages, and it's like, I'm sorry, I was playing video games. But that's the life I live. I'm sorry. Yeah, how can I be bored while streaming? Well, less boredom, more tiresome. I've been playing this game for so long, and I'm still trying to get like level 10. It just gets annoying trying to do the same thing for several hours. But I know the question. It's like, yeah, you can't actually get bored while streaming, because that's the whole point of streaming, is to have fun. Especially when you technically can stream what you want. Even though it is nice to stream what the viewers want to see. But you always like give them options, so that it's like you still are playing something you want to play, you let them pick. Like, technically I have a library I can have them pick from. But that library is so small that it doesn't matter too much. At least I got to the Dire Ursa. Alright, how do I want to... I'm going to try to take out as many smaller Grimm as possible for free experience, because as soon as you kill the Dire Grimm, or the Dire Ursa, the level switches to underground. Oh yeah, no, see, I know for a fact I'm gonna get to level 10 now. Like, if I don't make it to level 10... Yeah, I know what you mean. I technically, like, my room is open for viewers. It's just, you know, I don't really state that, I guess. I should probably state that more often. Holy shit, he does that much damage. The music that plays while this guy is here is amazing, though.
Yeah.
That guitar riff, go! Such an epic feel.
Isn't it like part of,
It seems like it's something from out of volume 3. That's the problem with me. It's like, wait a sec.
No, I see it's out of volume 2. Caffeine.
No, it's not from Caffeine. It is not from Caffeine.
No, it just sounds like it, though.
It does have the same feel. Well, although it says I have zero deaths, I died. Rest in peace, solo play of this game.
Students, we want in. Where are we? Ah, thank goodness. I'm afraid we have not read something. This area has been even more dangerous since our last visit. So be careful.
Well, at least the game's the canon story of the show still applies here.
A bit, yeah.
Because he talks about since the last time we were here, and it's like, yeah, that means this game takes place after the events of RWBY in general. Oh yeah, I get that also. Endemic is the streaming to show off games that you love, and that's what I honestly want to do. If I'm gonna play a game, well, this is the thing for me. If I don't own the game, I don't want to play it, probably, unless I just haven't had the money. But the other thing is, I definitely I definitely need to get back to streaming Xenoblade, because honestly, I like that game too much, and it's... Honestly, I started streaming it, and I got to a certain point, and I need to finish the game. I should finish that game. It's so much fun. Alright. Yeah, I should reach level 10. This isn't even a question anymore. I'm going to reach level 10. Okay, that was stupid. But I'll take that. Calling Ruby OP. I literally just sniped out two Grimm from across the map. Wow. Well, this is the intro to, this is from when they were in the Emerald Forest. The song right now. This is actually like part of, I think this is actually part of Red Like Roses Part 2. Or at least this is what leads into the Red Like Roses Part 2. Yeah, Yang's attack, range attack is really, really good. When you use it in the right spot, at least. I've had times where it's actually screwed me over, though. Legitimate strategy. There we go. Kill all those Grimm. More free experience. Alright. Get away from me. Where's the next one gonna spawn at? Was it only one per player? Oh, it's one per player, okay. Okay, I'm getting extremely lucky with these XP orbs.
What was that thing? It appeared to be a creature of Grimm.
Yeah, that's definitely... Now that I'm listening to it more in depth, that is definitely Lindsay voicing Blake in this for whatever reason.
Excellent work, team.
Who?
The voice actress, remember how earlier you were talking about how the voice actress for Blake didn't voice Blake in this game? But
I believe so, yeah.
Yeah, the person who voices Blake in the show isn't voicing her in the game right now, at least. At least not in this version.
Hmm.
But you know who is voicing her?
Who?
The voice actress for Ruby. And her name is Lindsay. So when I said, I can definitely hear Lindsay in this Blake. Like, as soon as I hear Blake say anything, I can tell it's Lindsay. now that someone's told me that it's Lindsay, I'm like, oh shit, yeah, I can hear that. Thank you. Fuck you. Stupid Grimm. Okay, I'm Blake and I have to solo three Ursas. That's gonna be fun. Oh, fuck.
Yeah. Also, I found out something interesting.
What'd you find out?
At level 10, you don't get 1 point. You get 2 points.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
It's been a while since I've actually... I don't pay attention when I get to level 10 too much, so... I guess that's hard to notice, but yeah. That's
yeah,
cool.
I actually remember spending 1 point in, extra... special, and I'm like, well, I'm not gonna be able to hit level 10 this time, so I might as well put it in special. I'm like, and then I actually got further in with you guys. I'm like, oh, I'm actually gonna hit level 10. I kind of wish I actually saved it for that Quincendo. And then I hit level 10, and I go in, I'm like, oh, I got 2 points. Sweet.
Can that other Ursa die? Holy crap. There we go. Now it's just two.
So that means you can get a total of 11 points.
That's awesome. Just have to kill one more Ursa and I reach level 10. Come on. Yes! There we go. Got Fortunate Faunus. Blake has a random chance to gain one touch on defeating each enemy. That's awesome.
Congratulations on hitting level 10.
At least with Blake.
Ugh. I still can't believe you guys were playing as two Yangs and a Weiss, and me as RWBY, and I just kind of clocked house.
Well, that's because RWBY's a little OP.
A little?
A little.
That's a bit of an understatement.
That's the understatement of the year, I know.
Because she has all of her abilities are AoE based.
We didn't
Huh?
Endemic is in my chat. We didn't Reddit is what he says.
Okay. Ask him why the hell he ain't in the.
He can hear you, so like. Like, because your voice goes through my chat. Through my Steam stream.
By the way, get your ass in here.
Yep. There you go. Yeah, he definitely wants you to join back in Endemic. Join in the call at least, or the What else? Someone say?
There's no fuel left in the cart. Hurry, gather those dust crystals.
I'm glad now that I'm at this part of the game, all I literally have to do is gather dust and just run. And guess what Blake's really good at doing? Running.
Gotta go fast.
Left in the cart. Hurry, gather those dust crystals.
Ow, that's my aura. Stop depleting it, please. Sorry, base dust.
No fuel left in the cart. Hurry, gather those dust crystals.
And Demick says, you don't tell me what to do, you're not my real dad. Meaning if he doesn't want to rejoin, he doesn't have... Oh, okay, that was an interesting glitch. I'm going to circle around.
You're halfway there. Keep going. There's no fuel left in the cart.
I know. Shut up, Joel. I know. Freaking Joel Heyman, the voice of Dr. or Professor Ublank.
Yeah, I kind of figured that much.
He says he's just taking it easy right now. So he's been, because he's been streaming all day. He's been streaming for close to 12 hours. Dang. See, I only stream up to like 1 or 2 hours a day. Or 2 to 3 hours a day at most, actually. If I'm streaming more than that, it's because I have a reason to. I've never had a reason to stream that long. I usually have to be streaming with like a friend or something to stream that long. Plus, I usually don't have that much time to stream. Pro strats, run away! Oh my god. That was close. So much Grimm, too little time. See, this is how all this comes from me playing Black Ops Zombies. Black Ops 2 Zombies, at least. Learning how to train. Skills from Zombies really come in handy in this game.
They come handy in all games.
Well, not all of them. Some of them obviously don't lend themselves to that kind of gameplay. But a game like this, yeah, it definitely lends your hand when you're trying to run away from enemies. And group them together and stuff like that. Bam! God, please. Yeah, I know. It's not. I don't like Call of Duty for anything but zombies, though. So that's really all that really matters. Zombies is worth picking up Call of Duty for, in my opinion. That would have made for an uncomfortable parent-teacher conference. But it's an opinion.
Where in the world did the mutated Grimm come from?
Just like you have the opinion that says that only the original 150 Pokemon matter. There are so many fans out there that disagree with you. Here's my response to... If anybody says the original 150 matter, take it like people saying Black Lives Matter. No, Black Lives don't matter. All lives matter. So, in my opinion, all Pokemon matter.
Except for the stupid ones like vanilla ice and such like that.
Okay, well, you've got a point there.